They always say that if you're going to write a book, you should write about what you know. So perhaps it's no surprise that after adopting his son, author Daniel Ingram-Brown drew on his own experiences for his book. But he also enlisted the help of old Mother Shipton from his hometown of Knaresborough. The result is a book called Bee's Witch, and Daniel is on the line to tell us more. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Jonathan.
What's the book about? Because when you hear that a book is about adoption, I don't know, there is a sort of tradition through literature that adoption, orphans and things like that, there are Dickensian shades that hang over this subject that maybe you wanted to, challenge?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think that's right. Often, like in literature, the orphan or the adoptee can be like a bit of a plot device. You know, get rid of the parents, and then you've got a story because the child has to sort of go on an adventure or, you know, face their fears or whatever. I guess being an adoptive dad, I did want to challenge that. I wanted to present maybe a more realistic version of adoption, perhaps using some of my experience of being an adoptive dad and sort of going through that process. But then you also want to make it fun and interesting to read. And so it's got some magic in it. It's got my protagonist, Beatrice, meets the ghost of Mother Shipton, as you said, you know, the famous Yorkshire prophetess. And they trade stories, and it sort of helps Bee sort of come to terms with her past and take hold of her future.
I like the idea. And Mother Shipton, there is actually a sort of a quirk in the backstory to Mother Shipton that lends itself to this. Is that right?
Yeah, there is. Yeah, when I had the idea, I was sort of walking along the river in Knaresborough, and I knew I wanted to write about adoption, and I sort of saw the sign for Mother Shipton's cave, and I was like, oh, Mother, you know, it's in the title, it's about parenting and children, so the idea came from that. But when I researched her background, I realised that actually she was fostered. She was taken away from her birth mum and went to live somewhere else. So that was like a really nice sort of synchronicity that I discovered. So these two characters across different centuries realise they have quite a lot in common in a lot of ways.
It does feel like a light bulb moment when you knew that about Mother Shipton. What are some of the... I mean, we've talked many times on this programme about fostering and about adoption, particularly when local councils or organisations are appealing for foster parents. I've spoken to a lot of foster parents on the programme and people who've been fostered and adopted and heard about their various experiences. Some of them traumatic.
Yeah.
Not, you know, many of them have wrinkles in that relationship. Other people, I mean, I remember speaking to one couple and they had fostered or adopted tens of children in their lifetime and they have such happy, long-lasting relationships with them. What are some of the issues that arise around adoption?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, so I get on, you know, we adopted my son when he was 6 and a half, so he was quite old. He's now coming up to 16. And we've had some brilliant memories and, you know, we get on really well, which is brilliant. We like to play board games together, all of those sorts of things. But I guess in terms of the sort of issues that children might face, it's things like when you're in school and you're told to sort of write about your family or your family tree. And some of those things we sort of take for granted about people's backgrounds. And for adoptees, they don't know what that background is, and that can be something that causes anxiety or, you know, is a difficulty in terms of sort of understanding identity. So I guess one of the things I wanted to talk about in the book was the idea that it's really good to know our whole story. So my character sort of has to own her own story, and that's sort of what Mother Shipton is encouraging her to do, you know, the good and the bad, the difficult bits and the happy memories as well.
Has your son read the book? I mean, you said you adopted your son when he was 6 and a half. That's quite old. I mean, I remember people saying, you know, what parents who are adopting want, it tends to be a little baby. And that there is a group of children who are not little babies anymore, who do actually find it quite difficult to find adoptive parents.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, there's something that I think is really, really sad is that, that there is that group of children who maybe who don't get adoptive families. And 6.5 is quite old, and we deliberately went for a slightly older age because of that. My son has read the book. When I first came up with the idea, I rushed home. I've had this brilliant idea, and I wanted to tell him about it, partly because I wanted him to be happy with me writing it. And he said, I told him the idea, and he said, I wrote that story a couple of weeks ago in school. And he said he'd written this story about him running away from home and hiding out in Mother Shipton's cave. And I was like, yes, you did. You told me about that. So I'd obviously sort of locked it away in the back of my head and then had my own brilliant idea.
He wasn't accusing you of plagiarism, was he?
Exactly, he is. He wants the royalties.
Good man.
It's definitely, it's a shared story.
I know that over and above this, there are other things happening in your life. I mean, as if it's not exciting enough to have a book launch going ahead, then there are other things associated with Mother Shipton's Cave and at Mother Shipton's Inn.
Yes. So I've got a couple of like small launch events to mark the launch of the book. So I'm really excited to be partnering with Mother Shipton's Cave, and I'm doing some guided walks and readings from the book on Saturday the 31st of July and Sunday the 1st of August. So they're in the morning, 10:30 till about day. And if you go to Mother Shipton's Cave's website, you can buy tickets for that event. And then also on the 31st in the evening, I've got a book launch meal at Mother Shipton's Inn. And if people find my website, danielingrambrown.co.uk, the details are there about how to book for that. And then I've got a signing on the 4th of August at Castlegate Books in
You're a busy man. Yeah. Listen, we must wrap up in a second, Daniel, just because time is pressing. But what is your hope if somebody who was adopted was to pick up the book and read it, or somebody who has adopted a child or is thinking of adopting a child? What is your hope about the impact the book will have on them?
Yeah, I mean, I guess for someone who's been adopted who reads the book, I'd love it if they find something of themselves in the story, you know, that they're able to find a character that they connect with and see themselves reflected in the book. And thankfully, the feedback that I've had from adoptees, they do say that they find it quite realistic in that sense. And I guess for people who are going to adopt, I think it's maybe a book that would help people see some of the challenges, but also some of the hopes and the possibilities for forging a new future together.
That sounds very, very positive. Daniel, we must leave it there, but lovely to speak to you on the programme today.
Thanks for sharing some
time with us. That's Daniel Ingram-Brown, drawing on his own experiences, and his new book is called Bee's Witch. And as you've heard, there is a lovely local connection to it with the story of Mother Shipton as well, and all those special launch events coming up in the next few days as well. Go and have a look for him on the internet. He's called Daniel Ingram-Brown. It's BBC Radio York on a Tuesday. It's 14 minutes to midday. It's T-Rex.